Hey everyone, in this video, I wanted to show you how you could edit any PDF file for free. If it's your first time here, I make easy to follow tech tutorials 5 times a week, so please consider subscribing. So here I have a PDF file, and let me show you quickly the way Adobe wants you to edit a PDF. Adobe is the company that made PDF back in the 90s, so they have a program called Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, and that's the program they want you to use to edit a PDF. So when I open it with that, this is where I typically edit my PDFs, but this costs money and I wanted to show you a free option so you don't have to pay for this if you don't want to. But if you use this all the time, if you edit PDFs all the time, this is how simple it is. I open it with Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, I go to Tool, and then I click Edit PDF, and just like that, I could come here and edit. I could delete, I could type. It makes it super easy to edit a PDF just like that, where any other program does not make it this easy. This is the page for that program, and it actually is $14.99 a month right now if you pay annually. So if you do this all the time, this is a great way to do it. You could get Adobe Acrobat Reader, which is free, but this just lets you review and open PDFs, but doesn't let you edit them. This is the free one I wanted to show you. It's called PDFscape. I have a link in the description to both of these if you want to check them out. But let me show you how to edit in PDFscape. I have a different Adobe Acrobat tutorial on my channel, so check it out if you wanted to use that instead. But let's go ahead and open it here. I'm just gonna go here. And again, it doesn't matter if you're on Mac or PC. I'm on a Mac here, but the process is the same. Let me take this free PDF sample and put it here, and it's gonna upload it. Now, the issue with this is you're actually putting this in the cloud. So if you have a sensitive document, you really should use Adobe Acrobat for $14.95 a month. But let me show you how to edit it on here. So just like that, you open my PDF file, and I have some really simple options here. So I could come over here and click this text icon. And now I could drag, when I have this selected, I could drag anywhere in the document like this to create a text box. And once I create a box, I could start typing something new here. And I still have options for font size, bold, underline, all the things that you would have with text in any other program. So if I selected this, I could even change the color. It's really easy to do that here. Let me just go ahead and put that in the trash can. So that's how you would create new text. Now, to edit old text, this is what you gotta do. You gotta go to whiteout, so click whiteout here, and you gotta drag over an old text, and it will basically cover that old text up. So it actually doesn't delete it like Acrobat does, but this covers old text up. So now you could create a new text box. So if I wanted to create a new text box, I could create a new text box and type in my new text here, and it basically covers up the old text, and I could always delete this if I didn't want to, and or put it somewhere else. But you would use whiteout to cover old text just like that and cover entire paragraphs, and then use the text box to create new text box and type on top of it. So it's not as quick as editing the actual words. Only Acrobat could do that, but this is a free workaround that works pretty well. So what else can you do here? You could use freehand, and you could do signatures, and you could basically write like this. When you're done with it, you could click away from freehand, and you could always select something you don't like and just press this trash icon. It'll get rid of it just like that for you. You could add links, you could press more, and you could see some shapes, some check marks. Another handy one is you could add an image. So you could go here and upload an image from your desktop. You could basically choose any file you want. So if I wanted to choose this file, and it pops up here, and I could just put it anywhere on my document. I could resize it. I could hold shift if I don't want the aspect ratio to change like this. If I hold shift, it keeps it consistent like this. That pretty much works with most programs anyway. So let me show you a different part of this app. You could annotate, so you could do sticky notes, you could insert, strike through, all these things that you could do with other programs. And under pages, you could actually move your pages. So if I click move here, I could take the first page and make it page 3, for example. So if I press select, now you move the first page to page 3 and then moved everything else up. So I could select pages here and press move and move them around within the document to rearrange them. Or I could append, and append will allow me to bring a new PDF. So if I go here to desktop to this PDF file, I could combine PDFs like this, which is something that is a little bit hard to do if you don't use one of these programs. So this allows you to combine different PDFs. So that's under Pages, Append, and under Pages, Move, that's an option to move your PDF around. So under Insert, you could do simple edits with text using text and whiteout, insert images and links. And under Pages, you could move things around and append them by combining different PDF files. And once you're done, this is what you want to do. You want to go over here, and on the side of the document, you should see this icon, which lets you save and download. So let me go ahead and press that. And just like that, it downloaded it. So if I go ahead and open this, this is the document I just edited, saved to my desktop. Or if you just open it for you, you could come up here and press this icon right here. This will download it to your desktop. So let me exit out of here. And if you're gonna use this all the time, go ahead and register so you could save your documents on here into the cloud completely for free. The way they make their money is with these ads here. So if you see ads on the side, that's how this program makes their money, and that's how they're able to make it for free. But again, if you do this all the time, Adobe Acrobat is probably your best option. I know it's paid and this is a free video, but I just wanted to share that with you because this is made by Adobe, so is PDF. So it makes sense for them to charge for their own file editing. I hope you found this useful. Please give it a like and subscribe to this channel. I post easy to follow tech tutorials 5 times a week, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching.